Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the .NET MAUI Scheduler control. Using this scheduler control, you can manage time efficiently by scheduling and rescheduling events or appointments. You can also create recurring appointments, customize the look of the appointment, and group them based on the resources. Before proceeding, make sure that you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed in your machine. You should also have Visual Studio 2022 installed with the required .NET MAUI workloads. With that confirmed, let's start building an app. I open Visual Studio 2022 and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose .NET MAUI app and name my project Scheduler Sample. After that, I choose .NET 7 framework and click Create to complete the project creation. Alright, my default application has been created and is ready to use. So, inside this project, I want to show off a few important things. First, look at this dependencies section. You can see different dependencies like Android, iOS, Mac and Windows to build multi-platform apps with this .NET MAUI. Okay, next we'll see the .NET MAUI application's default output. Before running it, choose the Android emulator from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. Alright, the application compiles up a default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. And now, my application says, "Hello world. Welcome to .NET MAUI." So next, let me show you the steps to display Syncfusion .NET MAUI Scheduler in this page. First, I need to install the Syncfusion .NET MAUI Scheduler NuGet package. So, stop debugging and open the NuGet package manager. And in the Browse tab, I search for the Syncfusion .NET MAUI Scheduler package and install it in my project. Here, click OK to continue the installation. It takes a few seconds to complete the installation, so let's wait. Cool, this step got completed. So next, let's start to initialize the .NET MAUI Scheduler control. I open this main.xaml page and remove the default content from the content page section. In this page, I import the Syncfusion MAUI Scheduler control and to the local XML namespace, map the default project namespace. And finally, I include the .NET MAUI scheduler control here. Next, I need to register the handler for Syncfusion Core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. So, open the MAUI program file and add the Syncfusion MAUI Core hosting namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Core handler by making a call to the method configure Syncfusion Core. Okay, everything is configured. So, save the changes and run this application. Looking here, the MAUI scheduler control is displayed with the system's current date initially. Also, by default, the scheduler is loaded with the day view. Suppose I want to load with some other view, then I can choose any one of these views supported by Syncfusion MAUI Scheduler like day, week, workweek, month, and so on. Now, I am planning to display scheduler in week view, so define the view property and set its value to week. You can see the scheduler control loads the week view as its current view and displays the current date. Here, the scheduler is shown with the defined view alone. But, in some cases, you would like to display the scheduler in all the supported views. At that time, define this allowed views property and assign all the supported 9 views here. You can see the scheduler control loads in week view, but I can switch to different views by clicking the ellipsis icon and selecting a view from the list. For example, if I want to switch to month view, then click this option and it navigates to month view. Okay, now let's move on to today's date color. Check this today's date highlight color, it's in blue color by default. If I want to change that default color, then define today highlight brush property and set appropriate color to it. You can see the today's date background color has changed to red. As I said earlier, the scheduler is loaded with the system's current date by default. If I want to change that date, then define the display date property and specify some other date value to that property. And now, the scheduler control loads the given date in week view. Okay, next let's start to add an appointment to the scheduler control. Let me implement this with the MVVM pattern. So first, let me create a folder called View Model. Then add a class named Control View Model. And make this class as public. Next, I need to create view models. Before that, I would like to let you know that the Syncfusion MAUI Scheduler control provides the built-in class called Scheduler Appointment, which has the predefined fields like subject, start time, end time, background, and many more. Using these fields, I can directly create an appointment for the scheduler. From these set of available fields, I plan to use only two fields, namely start time and end time, to create an appointment on the scheduler. Alright, let's move on to the Control View Model class to create an appointment. Here, I define a bindable property called Scheduler Events of type Scheduler Appointment class, and add a constructor for the Control View Model class. Notice here, the Syncfusion MAUI Scheduler and System Collections Object Model namespaces are automatically imported, while adding Scheduler Appointment class and Observable Collection. Inside this constructor, to the Scheduler Events property, I add an appointment with the fields start time and end time, as I said before. Okay, the appointment creation is done, so let me navigate to the main.xaml page to bind the appointment to the scheduler. First, I need to add the binding context to the scheduler control and access the Control View Model class here using this local XML namespace. At last, define the appointment source property and bind the scheduler events to it. Checking the scheduler control now, you can see the appointment in the given time range. Note here that the appointment is displayed without the title. So, open the Control View Model class and add the subject field with the value client meeting. Also, I plan to change the background color for this appointment, so add the background property and set appropriate color to it. You can see the scheduler, the appointment is displayed with the defined subject and the background color changed to green. Okay, so far, I have shown you the steps to create an appointment with the default fields available in the built-in Scheduler Appointment class. That is, while creating an appointment, I used the same field name as it is defined in the Scheduler Appointment class. Suppose you want to add some custom fields of your own, then you can do that by creating a separate model class, similar to the built-in Scheduler Appointment class, and map the appropriate fields. Say for example, as a first step in defining custom fields, you need to define a model class with required custom fields, like event start, event end, name, and color. And these fields are equivalent to the built-in Scheduler Appointment class fields, like start time, end time, subject, and background. So now, using these custom fields, I can create an appointment for the scheduler. Once it has been done, I map these custom fields to the relevant fields in the scheduler appointment. To do this, first I create a folder and add a class named Control Model. Then, make this class as public and define the required custom fields with different names: event start, event end, name, and color with appropriate data types. Now, I am going to assign values for these fields. So, open the Control View Model class and define a bindable property, custom events, of type Control Model class. Inside this constructor, to the custom events property, I add an appointment with the fields, event start, event end, name, and color with appropriate values. Alright, an appointment creation is done, so move on to the main.xaml page to map these custom appointment fields. First, I will add the appointment mapping property and define the mapping class for scheduler appointments. Then, map those custom fields, name to subject, event start to start time, event end to end time, and color to background properties. Lastly, I will bind this custom events property to the scheduler's appointment source. You can notice that the scheduler control still displaying the appointment that is created with custom fields. Okay, next let's see how to change the first day of the week in the scheduler. Note here that the first day of the week is Sunday by default. If I want to change that day, then I can define the first day of week property and set its value to Monday. And here, the scheduler's first day of the week is Monday. Alright, now let's see how easily you can display week numbers in the scheduler. For that, I simply need to add the show week number property and set its value to true. See the week number displayed now. Okay, finally, I will show you how to hide the navigation arrow in the scheduler. In this scheduler code, I define the show navigation arrows property and set its value to false. Now, when you check the scheduler control, the navigation arrows are hidden. In this video, we have seen how to create a .NET MAUI app using Visual Studio 2022 and add a Syncfusion .NET MAUI scheduler control to it. We have learned how to add simple appointments to the scheduler and change the default date, view, today's date highlight color, and how to display week numbers. If you would like to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.